Hey there, everybody. It's Suzanne. I am just getting ready for our comfortable and confident inside and out show tonight. So let's see. I had invited Anna to join. We're being joined by Anna Sa. So hopefully she got the invite. A second while we figured out all this technology stuff. That might work okay. So Anna, did you get the invite? Let's see if we're live over here. So Anna, I don't see you yet, so let's see. Let me see. Oh, not yet. Okay, hold on a second. Let's see. All right. So it says that you were invited. I invited you. So I'm also going to turn on that you can request to be joined. So you can actually request. So you should be getting a request from me. You didn't get the request. Okay, hold on a second. Approved. Okay, let's see. Maybe it says that you're being added.
Hi. Can you hear me? I can't hear you.
You can't hear me?
You can't hear me?
Oh, now it's better. Now I got it.
Yeah.
But it goes on and in, you know? So it's not like I'm listening all the time. So let's keep trying.
Well, we're on live. Well,
we're on live now.
Thanks everybody.
It's just maybe get a little bit closer. Let's see if that's the problem. Yeah, it just keeps going on and off.
Okay. How is that a little bit better?
Oh yeah, much better.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
All right. Well, okay, awesome.
Good.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Although I still hear an echo a little bit.
Oh, yeah?
On my end, I'll just ignore it.
Well, everybody, thank you so much for being here.
This is one of our first shows of Confident Inside and Out.
And I'm welcomed by Anna Sa.
She's a wellness coach.
So I'm so excited to have her here.
And I just found her to be so fabulous.
So Anna, please tell us about yourself,
what you're passionate about,
what you do.
Sure.
It's my pleasure to be here too. So thank you so much for inviting me. When I met you, I was really happy that we had that connection as well, because it was just like one of those meetings that that we're going to go forward and have a good relationship and share good information and grow together. So thank you so much for inviting me. And we met actually because of my passion for yoga. I'm a yoga teacher. In reality, I came into the fitness industry as my profession, my main profession. I've always been into the fitness and movement and that recognition that you start with your body, the understanding that your body is a vehicle for you to get to know yourself. And I worked with that for years and years, but it got to a point that there was just something missing in there, this link that's missing. It couldn't be just the body, something more. And that's when I came across yoga, fell in love with yoga, and it helped me through so many challenges in my life to get to know myself better so I could go through those challenges with ease and understanding they will be lessened down in the future, down in the line. And we met because I'm a yoga teacher, and we met through friends in common and Shala that I teach, Anuttara Shala. And we get to know each other and to also get other things in common, which it is working with women and how we can help ourselves first, always. And through that understanding of ourselves, we can share and help other women that are also finding the same things across the way and in whatever we can help. And it's a pleasure, again, to be here so we can share that information. So
beautiful.
Yeah. Beautiful. So tell us what you do in your wellness coaching.
Yeah. So yoga is one of my passions, but recently also I have found another passion because I believe that wellness, and again, we're coming back to that background of in fitness, it is a connection, mind, body, and spirit. It's all three. With that being said, through my own journey and through my own search, I have come to the understanding that we have to work our bodies, yes. We have to honor this vehicle with what we eat and what we do, the way we move, the way we sleep, and everything else. But it's also very important to take care of the mind through meditation, relaxation, and other things that you can do to observe how this mind, the way that the mind is going. And of course, your spirit, get in touch with things that will bring you close to this higher energy, this higher force, whatever is your path to follow this. So for me, it's like wellness is everything, putting everything together. That's what I have found. And through that own search, I have come across many things. And one of them that I'm doing and loving it, it's called QHHT, Quantum Healing Hypnosis Technique, which it is incredible. It's a technique where we bring the person into a hypnotic state, but in a deeper state of hypnosis that we get in touch not only with a past life, but also in touch with this higher mind, this part of the subconscious mind that knows better, that knows the directions that you should take. And through that, a lot of healing happens because it's something that comes from you. The healing is you that's performing through knowing what the subconscious mind is bringing out in terms of messages. So this has been like a baby for me lately, and also the work with women, because through my own journey, I believe, especially you want to talk about confidence, and this is what we are talking about today, starts with you getting to know yourself, right? To going into the depths of understanding of who you are. Mm-hmm. And I see, and just taking for myself once again, that women have been disconnected with the fact that they are the ones that give life, that have life, can have life within them. And this by itself is a powerful tool, a powerful energy that we have within us. And we have grown to believe that we should be ashamed of our cycles, that we should be distant from our connection of being women, of creating life. And this is just the process of it. And this creates all kinds of disconnections also with the body image or the understanding of, right, what you are. You're not just the body. You are the giver of life. So for that,
we've been of our self-worth because of our being conditioned to behave in certain ways, where that we're just out of alignment
with who we are.
Yeah. I'm gonna finish a little bit of the THC so we don't lose the subject, but then I'm gonna come back into another passion of mine that is this self-discovery into the sacred feminine and understanding how we can use this cycle of life that we have every month, because we have it every month, even if we don't have life within us. but we have the cycle of birth, rebirth, death, the cycle of introspection, action within us every month, and we should take advantage of it instead of just ignoring or being ashamed of it and being mold by what society says, what is right and what is wrong.
We're all trying to question that now.
What's going to feel best for me and for being in your body, how to get there.
And it comes also from a collective consciousness of us thinking that the success or the happiness is out there somewhere, right? It's somewhere. When I get that perfect body, I'm going to be happy. Or when I get the perfect house, if I have the perfect house, I'm going to be happy. And once again, it all comes back into going internally and going back within you so you can find the answers and understanding that the happiness is inside already. It's not out there anywhere. And that comes back to the key agency because you go in to find the answers. And usually it's a very profound experience because after the fact, it's almost like a door is open, a doorway is open, where more answers keep coming in. And because you're dealing with the subconscious mind, you go into this land of unknown that has a different language, which is the language of the dreams. So a lot of dreams come as part of the process of keep getting into the answers. And it's almost like you gain a feeling of what it is to be in touch with that subconscious mind and that intuition, because you had the feeling while you were in the session. So every time that an intuition comes and have that same feeling, you know, oh, that's right, I should follow that.
Yeah, and you're building that confidence, believe that inner voice.
Exactly. So it has been a beautiful tool for me to be able to help others in this passion of mine, which it is wellness, awareness of body, mind, and spirit, and coming in the whole complete package of what that means. To be well. And then another passion of mine is about the sacred feminine, like we're talking about. You know, I've been studying my own cycle. Like the phases of the moon. Like our cycles are pretty much like the moon. We are now in the new moon. And when we receive our period, it's the new process, right? It's the new cycle beginning because one cycle just ended. So it's using that energy of the new, stepping in the new cycle. And then when we are growing to become full again, to receive life, we go through this process of action and going after things. But it's very important to notice those cycles because when you're in the new moon, when your process of shedding, when your process of coming down, it's important for women to go and introspect and feel the power of the energy of introspection and getting to know what's coming out, getting to know themselves instead of pushing away what we call the sadness or the woman is crazy because she's in that period that is right before she received her period and she's going crazy, right?
Right.
And that's what society tells us, that we are going crazy, but we're not going crazy. We are just having so much power into having our peers to give us this moment to actually go in and understanding why we are going crazy.
But like you said, we've been so ashamed about the whole process that we just should aside and the function of the monkeys that we've learned to embrace our unique cycles, and what that means, what powerful women we are.
Yeah, and in the process too, we end up, like, if you look into the big picture of the idea of the women, of the mother, of the giver of life, we end up within this society and the ideas of view of society also hurting our own mother, which it is the Mother Earth, because we are down wearing tampons and all kinds of toxic products within our own bodies, and then we threw it away into the earth, into another like powerful feminine force, and we are like destroying it. So I believe, and I say I joke, but I think that this is true, that women are burning sticks in the past because they knew their power, they were really like good witches, you know. They knew that they could introspect, find the answers, come out with the answers, and perform magic because of the answers they come out with, you know, and use that power of life, which is the power of transformation, of creating something, to create something from themselves.
Yeah, I totally get what you're saying.
That the divine master
are the power,
of the divine.
And we have to appreciate the masculine in all of us, and in that threat, the masculine self, it really used its force to shun and push the feminine down. And then we just become confused and divided and separated, and our power really comes in connection with each other, and now with the realm of the feminine, and the age of Aquarius, we're all coming back into, especially as the feminine, learning that power again, and learning how to harness it in a way for everyone, that's going to be something.
Most definitely. If you look into the natives and the traditions that they have, the women and the tribes, they had the tradition of the red tents. So what they would, what they would do is just go when they had their periods, they would go away to those tents and they would have ceremonies for themselves, like just for the introspection, for understanding that process, and to also like get together and be creative and create things. And they would come back with answers for the whole tribe. They would do nothing but that, because even the tribe and the men of the tribe, they would understand that. And they would actually would be part of the tradition because they would come back with answers, not only for themselves, but for the whole tribe. Again, it's using that witchcraft, right? Using that, the answer to find, you know? So this became the patriarchal ways of seeing, because this is society, right? The society is just that. It's, if you think about the idea of sun and moon, or feminine and masculine, society is the pushing, is the action, is the sun, is the male energy that we all have within us. But it's really extreme to push down the feminine, right? So it creates like completely unbalanced. That's not, society is not balanced at all. So we keep striving. What it is success for the society is to have the big houses, to have the big car, and also it is the women with the perfect body to please the man and to please the visual and the material things, right?
Well, those are all just the feminine attempts to be able to survive in the way that the masculine devises the game of life.
Mm-hmm. Of life.
So now we're like,
we're
building our own world.
We're building our own world.
Yeah, like I said, is this era of Aquarius, right? Of illumination, of us putting light into what it's like, this imbalance that's happening. And it's an opportunity also for the masculine to have some healing on that process as well. I believe that we are in the process of healing of the sacred feminine and the sacred masculine. For us to understand, I even like posted something about it the other day, because it's kept coming like messages, you know. This other thing that happens too when you get in touch with your cycle, it's just like you open the channel to have messages coming and coming. And the messages that came that week was about, I have been seeing a lot of like abuse, sexual abuse into the spiritual realm, like spiritual leaders getting into cases of abuse and with women. And there are many cases like that in Brazil happening right now. Even John of God, I don't know if you heard of him. He's a very good idea. So it's happening over and over and over. And what it came to me is that this is a strong opportunity for healing for both masculine and feminine. Because the women are not victims. We should not put ourselves in this position of victimhood. We are powerful. We are the givers of life. We should receive this respect from the male. And men are not predators. They shouldn't come to us with this idea that they are predators, that they come to dominate us. They should come to us with the respect of somebody that will create life if they give us the seed, that we will transform that into life. So it's an opportunity for us to look that this is happening, and for both come to a place of healing, masculine and feminine, not separation, but union. It's just like, okay, so look at what's happening. It's an opportunity for both to look at it and rise together into the power again of the balance.
Right. It's definitely a changing of the guard this year. And yeah. allowing the women to have permission to explore our voice and our senses, like no other time that we've known. That we can really embrace that and experience it in a way that brings that unity that we're all craving so much. You know, and a lot of women struggle with anxiety because we have been conditioned away from ourselves
and brainwashed to believe that we aren't aligned with who we are.
And so when we start to feel certain ways about ourselves, about life,
we realize that it doesn't fit into how we describe the external.
So we feel very anxious about how we're supposed to honor what we're experiencing.
That we shut it down and we're accommodating the external.
And what I'm trying to show a little bit is that when you come into yourself, embrace that experience, help your body process through it, that we can build resilience for it, and honor it as a gut sense of a direction where we could go, not betray yourself and continue to do things outside of yourself.
Exactly. So it's going in. It's always going in, you know, and like you said, it's just going in and find it now and through the body, express that. And you have many ways of expressing and working with the healing. That could be tapping, could be yoga, could be dancing, could be so many things. Painting and being creative.
Singing, chanting, all of it.
Exactly. So it's about coming together and like helping each other. And then we get out also of this idea that the patriarchal energies put it into us as well, which it is, it's like you gotta compete, you gotta go against the other person so you can be better than the other person. And then we have in between us women this competition. It's just like, I think it's so sad that that's what happened to us, but at this point women are grieving the loss of time. For having had that experience of being in competition with another woman, an exercise that I recommend on this trip is to smile at another woman randomly, just smile and give her a smile and connect with you in that easy way, start to break down some of those walls of competition and resentment that have been built up by the masculine of the year.
I also was looking
into the Greek goddesses and the archetypes of women. They are very interesting too, and how you can use those archetypes to recognize your own archetype, right? And then when you look at the other, you're not jealous of the other. You still have this archetype on you of women, which might be whatever, Persephone, for example, like the one that goes into action, you know, like. So you're jealous of her because she has this archetype, but you also have within yourself. Just go look into that energy. Go understand what that is. And all that jealousy of she has it and I don't have it. And then getting into that competition simply goes away. So it's important for us to help each other instead of going against each other, right, in this moment. But it's happening. I see it happening. It's beautiful.
Yeah, I love it.
And I think that your whole package of wellness, and that we have to come out of lots of different angles, and it'll be all of the skills and that we're going to collaborate and share all of it.
And that's what total wellness is about.
Exactly, and we are creative. That's so many things that you go and you have to do what follow what goes into your heart. That sense of purpose, right? What is purpose? Is the not what you do for your job. It could be even better if it is, because if it pays your bills, your purpose in life. But it's usually related to help somebody else. It's something that's going to make your heart smile and you're just like, you're not here waiting for
being in service.
Yeah, because you are in service of others. So find that which it is unique to you, and that's no competition there. It's going to be you, you know, even if I have somebody else that does PhD or teach yoga, does the same things that I do. Still, it's going to be a different energy of what I do, the things I do, the way I do it. And we can collaborate always. We can just help each other to become better. It's time.
I really enjoyed this conversation with you.
Yeah, definitely. You can find me here on Facebook. You can find Anasa Wellness. It's my page on Facebook. And I'm also on Facebook as Anasa, and on Instagram, Asana by Anasa, Asana, the yoga practice. And it's easy to remember because my name, Anasa, if you go backwards, is Asana. So some people say, oh, you are meant to be a yoga teacher for sure. So you can find me there. You can message me, direct message me. And I am also offering a 30-minute consultation for everybody that watched this conversation that we had. And we can talk about your goals, where you want to go, and how we can put this all together, this whole package together, and grow together.
How should they get in touch with you?
They can get in touch with me in direct message here on Facebook or whatever is the outlet that they would prefer.
Okay, fabulous.
If you go on my page, you can find my email there.
Gotcha. I have all of the information in the description about you, so I'll make a mention about your offer. I'll have them come to you for a conversation.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for having me again.
Oh yeah, look forward to being with you.
Yeah, tomorrow is my birthday, so it is my gift. Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, it is. Interesting. I was teaching classes today, and today is a new moon, Aquarius. And tomorrow I get on my new sun cycle. So again, the balance, right? The sun and the moon coming together. They are the new moon, the new sun, and let's go.
I love it. You're an Aquarius sun. I'm actually an Aquarius moon, and it's an Aquarius new moon, so I'm kind of excited to see what this new moon is going to bring for me as an Aquarius.
Very good.
Well, thank you again. Thank you everybody for watching us live, or you watching us for the replay. I'm just so glad you got a chance to meet me. Beautiful soul, so much to share with you. Please, please reach out.
Thank you so much.
All right. Good night, everybody.
Bye.